The LA Rams are back on track with last week's win in Detroit, and with two games left in the season, we're looking for one more road win against the Arizona Cardinals, not just to go perfect on the road this year, but also to sweep our division. We've beaten Seattle twice, we've beaten San Fran twice, and now we're looking for our second win against Arizona. And it's not Thursday, but both teams wearing their throwback uniforms. We got a game plan in place, and that's one big reason I've adopted the goat elbow sleeve, trying to be like Kobe, trying to be like MJ, lead this team to another championship. Starting from the 13, Goff throws to Carver, and Carver coughs it up. Chandler Jones on the recovery, and we give it right back to Arizona after we got a pick on Carson Palmer. Goff hits Carver across the middle. Carver gets hit by Tyrann Mathieu, coughs it up, and unfortunately, our defense played well to get the game started, but we end up giving the ball right back to Arizona, and we can't get the stop this time around. We now trail by 7. Next drive starting from the 19 and giving this one to Todd Gurley, able to find some room and find 6 yards as we kind of go back to what we normally do to get a possession started, not trying to switch it up like we did when Gage Carver fumbled. Third down, big catch for a big first down, working upfield and hit by Tyrann Mathieu shy of the 40, but the Rams find a first down. From the pistol, Goff going play action. We'll throw this one downfield. Jump ball one-on-one, and I get 2 hands on it, but I can't haul it in, and Peterson almost came away with the pick off the tip. Now it's second down. Lot checks in on second down. Goff looks to throw left side. He's got Gage Carver across midfield up to the Arizona 47. This time actually holding on to the football. Now it's first and 10, working downfield pretty smoothly. Goff throws it a little too late. Could have been picked off there by Kirby. Good thing Carver came back to the football, although he did lose 2 yards in the process. A little bit of time left in the first quarter, trying to go screen outside, and Carver just working towards the sideline, not following his blocks upfield, and that ends up only finding 4 yards. Now facing 3rd and 8, Goff stepping up in the pocket, loses the football, scooped up by the Rams as we nearly turn it over again, and this is Campbell just blowing past Jamon Brown. That looked more like a forward pass to me, but this offensive line gets paid too much money to give up pressure that quickly. But regardless, not in field goal range, we get the ball back to the Cardinals. They turn it back over. Carson Palmer, 2 picks in the first quarter, sets us up at the 15-yard line. We go wildcat to the left side and able to high step in for the touchdown as the goat elbow sleeve is coming to play here, and I almost hit a cameraman. Watch out for a lawsuit, but a great job blocking there by Corey Harkey, taking out Chandler Jones, and I use my speed to break free for the big-time touchdown, and we are tied just like that. All it took was 1 mistake and 1 big run, but the Cardinals drive back downfield. They are up by another touchdown, and we go back to the ground game with Todd Gurley. He ends up losing 1 to start this possession. 2nd and 11, Goff looking to throw, quickly throws my way. That is caught and fighting through 3 defenders for an extra 2 or 3 yards. Down to the 39 again. First down, Goff has time, throws this one towards the left side. That is a completion, and we're back into Arizona territory as Gage Carver again, getting separation this time from Kirby, makes the catch and picks up a big time first down. Coming up big since that first fumble on our first play of the game. Second down, going back to the ground game with Gurley. He's able to get up to the 44-yard line, so he better game this time around, but still not being very consistent up front with the blocking. And now it's 3rd down and 6. We're going to throw this one again as Goff throws towards the outside for Gage Carver again. That's another first down up to the 35-yard line, now 34. Goff, quick throw and a tight throw into a tight window. Peterson all over me, but making the catch in traffic. That'll set us up 3rd and 2, trying to find a first down, going toss outside, and I can't get to Kirby. This game just doesn't let me block the way I want to block sometimes. A lot of these outside run plays, I'm forced to take a step either up or I'm taking a step towards the left or the right. This time I'm forced up, and all I'm trying to do is shadow Kirby so I can set that edge block, and I can't do it. So we settle for a field goal, but we get the ball back, and that's going to give us some time to at least try to get a touchdown to take the lead or maybe get another field goal to cut the lead down to 1. But not a great start that play as Goff's forced to throw it away. 2nd and 10 across the middle. There goes Jason Witten having a pretty slow year. Would love to see more from him, but he just hasn't been consistent enough out there on the field. 3rd down for the Rams. Lot checks in as Goff will throw it downfield. 1-on-1 against Peterson. And I lose this battle with Patrick Peterson. He picks it off. And it's not like Goff really gave me a chance there. That ball was way too far inside for me to make a play on it with Peterson's position. And Goff throws, I don't know, what is that, interception number 24, 25 this year. As you'll see, I mean, Peterson, and to make it even worse, he pulled it in with 1 hand. I mean, come on, this is unbelievable. Unbelievable. Goff never gave me a chance. Here comes Carson Palmer. 12 for 15 start with a touchdown over 100 yards, but also throwing two INTs. And we're looking for a third, but we don't get it. But we do get a stop and get the ball back with 21 seconds. So we'll go with screen, trying to work this one right side. I'm almost wrapped up behind the line, but I break free down the right sideline looking for a block from Witten, but he's too slow. But I'm out of bounds at the 31-yard line, 12 seconds left. What a play, getting us in field goal range to end the second quarter. That was Gage Carver with the weak block, and Patrick Peterson and Justin Gilbert couldn't make the play. Almost outran Tyrann Mathieu, but he's got enough speed to close out the corner. And that would take us to the third quarter. Rams down by one to begin the third with the football, trying to put together a drive and take the lead via field goal, via touchdown, whatever. Got to get downfield and find some points. Jason Witten in motion on first down and going to Ty Gurley. And he finds his best carry of the game so far. 8 carries and 13 yards. We are struggling on the ground, but still in this ball game. 3rd and 4. Goff looking to throw. Throws right side underneath. And that will be good enough for first down. Maybe that's good for 4. And that will convert. Nice catch by Jason Witten. New set of downs. Goff looking to throw again. Throws my way as I make the catch. Get nailed by Kirby. But holding on to the football for a pretty solid game. Good for 6 yards. Another third down coming up, 3rd and 3 from the 40. Goff looking to throw, and we'll get this one off underneath again. Another 3-yard gain. Will that be enough to convert? The Rams are stopped short, and we'll give the ball back to Arizona. But Arizona also goes 3 and out, and they'll give the ball back to us. And this is going to be a pretty solid punt with a pretty solid chance to be returned, maybe for a touchdown. Haven't seen one in quite some time. Get past the first guy, but can't get away from the second. That was Gilbert making the tackle, and we'll start from the 36. Arizona comes out stacking the box with their safeties as we'll go to the ground game anyway with Gurley, and he's got another short gain, good for about 3 yards. Not seeing too much this ball game on the ground. 2nd down, going back to Gurley right side this time, and Gurley squeezes through, finds 9 yards, and we're near midfield. Solid carry that time around. Just not seeing that consistently. 2nd and 4, Julius Lott, the rookie, checks in, carries upfield, and will pick up a 1st down. The rookie just running north and south, finding yardage when he can. And moving those chains. 1st down from the 41. Goff looking to throw towards my side of the field in the triple coverage. Are you kidding me? That could have been picked off by Tyrann Mathieu. That could have been picked off by anybody. But there was no way I was going to catch that football. Got to make better decisions. 2nd down and 10. Rams going to the ground. Gurley able to find some yardage this time around. Up the middle, finding 5 yards. 6 yards, actually. And we're down to the 35-yard line looking for another 3rd down conversion. Goff rolling out and is brought down behind the line by Zach Kerr. Goff gets taken down, loses 10 yards, and we're out of field goal range. And Ramon Brown gets beat again. Spin move by Kerr leaves Brown stumbling. Goff, you got to get rid of the football here. You cannot take the sack, and that's exactly what he did. And it's still a 13-14 ball game as Arizona still is struggling to move the ball down the field on offense. But we're going to try to find something through the air here with a good completion outside to, I believe, Cabrera. Getting close to the 4th quarter, 18 seconds left. Goff throwing across the middle, gives it right back to Arizona. Cornelius comes away with the INT. And make that another game for the Rams this year with 3 turnovers. Normally it's 3 INTs by Goff, but this week it's 2 INTs and a lost fumble by Gage Carver. But this is just a case of being in the right place at the right time. Goff overthrowing Britt, and Cornelius underneath got the INT. Arizona checking back in on offense in the 4th quarter, adding 3 points after the turnover. We're down by 4 with 9:20 to go, trying to at least get back into scoring range and actually score this time around. And we'll find a couple yards there on the screen. 2nd down coming up for the Rams from the shotgun and going run right side for Gurley, able to find some decent yardage. But still not finding enough to boost his average over 3 yards a carry, still sitting at about 2.5. Big 3rd down coming up for the Rams. This is Goff dropping back to throw. Takes a big hit as he gets rid of the football, but finds me down the right sideline. Patrick Peterson gets beaten. I'm high-stepping in and diving for the Rams touchdown. So Peterson beat me earlier. I beat him right back for my 15th receiving touchdown of the year, and we are tied at 20. As we're heading back on the field in the 4th quarter, 7:03 to go. Arizona has a field goal after our touchdown. And we're going to get going on the ground game once again, trying to get outside. And Gurley is wrapped up behind the line and loses 4 yards. This offensive line needs to be reshuffled or something. 2nd and 14, coming down the Wildcat, trying to find something. And unable to break outside. Great tackle there by Deion Buchanan, keeping me for a short gain. And that will bring up 3rd and 14 for the Rams. We'll come out 4 wide. Goff looking to throw and will run out of time trying to find Witten across the middle, but Chandler Jones there again. But our defense keeping the clamps down on the Cardinals. No score from them after we go three and out, and we're going to get the ball back with 4:30 to go and try to get this ground game going to at least work down some of this clock. Good game, good for about 3 yards. Second and seven, Carver in motion. Goff looking to throw down the seam. He's got Lance Kendricks near the 40-yard line. They just left him completely uncovered. All the linebackers came on a blitz. Goff just looking down the seam, trying to find his best option. That time it was Lance Kendricks. This game going down to the wire in the fourth quarter. Same thing with the San Fran-Seattle game. They are tied at 17. A little more time left in that game as we're getting close to the two-minute warning, but that would be a huge upset for the Seattle Seahawks if they lose to the 49ers. That could keep them out of the postseason. Third and inches going to Gurley, and it looks like he's got enough for a first down, and indeed he does. The Rams keep this drive moving. Ball at the 47-yard line, minute 30 to go, going to the outside on the jet sweep and finding a first down, getting out of bounds in field goal range at the 37. Minute 25 to go, Rams almost out of here with the win, but we just got to get a little bit closer and work off a little more of this clock. First down, Gurley gets the football, carries upfield, and Bruce Arians calls his first timeout, knowing that his Cardinals, they are in trouble. Second down and five, Gurley gets it once again. Carries will not get the first down this time, but finds a solid gain, good for about four. And that'll take us down to the biggest third down of the game. Third and one, 1:17 left in the ball game. Goal line set for the Rams in a give to the fullback. This is Corey Harkey finding the first down, getting 2 yards, and Arizona calls their final timeout, and they are done. That is the ball game. Rams win 23-20, working down the clock and getting a field goal, and we sweep the division. And not just that, we just flipped our season results from last year, as last year we were perfect at home, went 8-0 and went 4-4 on the road. This year, perfect on the road, 8-0 and having a chance to go 5-3 with a win in next week's season finale, or regular season finale, against the Redskins. Of course, Jared Goff struggled this game. Todd Gurley, you know, 21 carries, 56 yards, got yards when he needed them, but wasn't a great game. Gage Carver, 8 receptions, 47 yards. Would have liked to see more from him. I mean, he's 6'6", 221. It would have been a really nice thing to see him be more involved in the pass game, but he's really fallen off in the second half of this season. Carson Palmer, not a bad game. David Johnson also, you know, not a bad game. The Rams and the Cardinals were very similar, but the Cardinals were horrible on third downs. 3 of 12, 25%. That is not going to win you any games. And we will move on to the final game of the season, Week 17, the Rams and the Redskins. Both teams itching for a first-round bye in the playoffs. Both teams are now 12-3. The Redskins also hoping to avoid a tie this ballgame, as that could get them the lead in the NFC East, or win them the NFC East. And on the AFC side, here are the Steelers, 14-1 so far. They have been playing really good football and clearly the favorite to advance to the Super Bowl. But here's your look at the roster for Washington. Pretty much the same team we played last year, but you know, this team a little better. Kirk Cousins obviously still here playing pretty okay, not asking for any trades yet, but why would you when you've got pretty good talent on this team? Josh Norman still here. This is going to be the matchup to watch out for. Josh Norman, Breshad Breeland, Kendall Fuller. We've got a chance to win this game as long as we stay within our game plan and that game plan works. So it's time for our final home game of the season, and that will take us hopefully into a postseason run that ends in another Super Bowl. But thank you all for tuning in to another episode of the Madden 17 Wide Receiver Player Franchise. Hope you enjoyed. Getting real close to season 3, but if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like. If you're new, subscribe, and I will see you guys next time as we're looking to take down the Redskins. Have a nice day. See you later.